Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Oracle after its fiscal fourth quarter results topped analysts' forecasts. The tech company shares popped 13% in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of U.S. telehealth company LifeMD, which reported a successful financial year in 2023 with substantial revenue and subscriber growth. LifeMD shares surged 8% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Boeing, and another plane of the embattled plane maker was involved in what was called a mid-air technical event. The LATAM Airlines plane inexplicably dropped abruptly mid-flight, leaving over 50 people injured. Boeing shares fell 2% in the pre-market.
Asian markets ended Tuesday trade mostly higher. The Hong Kong Hang Seng outperformed, jumping 3%, fueled by a rally in tech stocks. Among the movers on the index was Xiaomi. The Chinese firm's share surged 11% after it announced it will start deliveries of its first electric vehicle this month. Meanwhile, Hong Kong shares of sportswear and equipment firm Li Ning also jumped. That's on reports its owner, billionaire and Olympic champion Li Ning, is taking the company private. Now here at home, the local market saw modest gains with value turnover reaching 5.4 billion pesos.
The sharp rally of the overall market right now may be challenged in the near term as we are prone to pullbacks and profit taking. In terms of the PSEI's current range, we're looking at 66 to 67 as a major support for the PSEI's current uptrend. But 68 seems to be holding as a shorter term support level.
Washington's trade and investment mission to Manila ends on a high note with U.S. officials calling the Philippines more business-friendly. The delegation led by U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo met with Filipino business groups Tuesday. Raimondo lauded the government's efforts to cultivate a more welcoming business climate for foreign investors. 22 American companies that took part of the mission earlier committed to invest over $1 billion in high-impact industries such as renewable energy and digitization.
President Marcos, it seems to me, is doing all the right things to make your country more business-friendly, easier to do business in, and that's just music to our ears in the U.S. and to the delegation that I brought. The message that we are hearing, you know, the legislation that the Philippines has passed allowing for private sector ownership of infrastructure makes public-private partnerships easier.
During the trade mission, the foundation of Filipino-American singer Alan Pineda, known as Apple the App, inked an agreement on training young Filipinos in e-vehicle mobility with the Asian Development Bank and Arizona-based Legacy EV. Tech giant Microsoft, meanwhile, expressed interest in training Filipinos about artificial intelligence and cybersecurity fluency through its certificate programs.
The thing to really focus on is expanded broadband connectivity, expanding skilling across nonprofit organizations and through the government, and really ensuring that as we bring broadband and skilling, we're focusing on anchor institutions, and then we will expand out from there.